Good morning. So today, we need to see what we can do about monitoring AT-SPI events after yesterday. It's not yesterday, was it yesterday? A couple of days ago. My session ended with me not really getting very far with doing that using a library. So we're going to have to do it from scratch, I think. We're going to have to build some sort of DBus interface that monitors the events that we need to capture keyboard strokes and window events for when a window is shown or hidden and stuff like that, so that we can then do auto expansion of snippets. So where are we going to go for that? So let's have a look. In my Scratch, what was I up to? Yeah, let's look at that. DBus, go DBus project. So double check this is up to date before we carry on. Clean. Okay, that's not going to do it. That's good. Okay. So we need some info before we get going. What we're going to probably need to do is build a little spike, little client. Let's see how that goes. Let's double check that this works with the client stuff, that everything's okay, and then we'll do the do. So I'm going to have two things on the go here. Check if they did. Okay. Right, over here, I'm just going to run the little server. Go run server. Okay, and now I'm going to run the client. There you go, it worked. Good, okay. So we know that this version is doing the right thing there, which is good. What else have we got in here that we can see? I wonder if there's anything here that I can use. As an example. Okay. Don't think I can use that. The monitor was different than I expected, I think. Okay. So that is monitoring notifications, I think. Yeah, well, it says so by the bottom. So that could be something that I use in my little test. Although it is doing proper monitoring stuff on the wheels, so it's not really what I want. We could try it. Let's do a little test on it. Could get quite busy, couldn't it? So go run monitor. And over here, let's do, just see what the notifications one does. Oh, that's easy enough. Okay, so that'll ping the DBus notification thing. So I should be able to do go run notification. Yeah, it saw it. Okay. I guess I should be able to do like notify, send, hello. Hello. So that's the actual system utility for sending notifications, and you'll see it pop up, hopefully, and hopefully get caught here. Well, I didn't. Oh, I've turned off notifications. Yeah, because I don't want anything pinging. Yeah, but it did work. Got a hello world. Okay. Okay, so I might be able to use something similar for just checking what's going on with AT-SPI stuff. If I just give it a little alter. So, let's do. I think it's called an alley. It's an alley interface. I'll have to go check all the stuff in a second. So I think I have to do a little bit of mucking about with addresses and things, but this might be a start. Might be easier to do this in GoLand as well, at least then I'll have auto-completion and stuff going on as well. Okay, let's do that. Now, did I have that project open before? No. Okay. Right. Examples. Monitor. Okay. You probably didn't even see that. It was behind my face, probably. Right. Okay, let's see. What can we do here? And why is that yellow? Oh, errors. Okay. Yeah, this is all going to have to change. But there's somewhere to start. I think. So I think the session bus should be okay. But then I think I have to go get a an address for the bus and all this kind of stuff. I've done some work with when I was originally doing Snippet Pixie. Well, I don't know, a while ago. Investigated. Here we go. So. Now, maybe here. All right, that's the top level. Blimey, that's bright. Is there not a dark mode? Eesh. Okay. Right. Interesting. Okay, there's different stuff here. Let's have a look at this readme. Okay. Right, so I need to connect. I need to connect to org.a.bus. And its object, that. And call get address. Which gives me the true address of the DBus service as such for this. Let's have a look. And then I'm going to have to go look for which events and things I can look at, subscribe to, and stuff. Okay, let's have a play then. I'm going to try, basically try and get to the point where this connects to the, what's it called? Ali bus, yeah, just Ali. That's 11, isn't it? Okay, so we're going to connect to the session bus first. Think. Yeah. And then I don't think I need to do this rule stuff yet. But we'll see. Let's try. So I've got, let me think, I've actually got code in the new version of Snippet Pixie. That might help. Wait, when it does that. Right. Let's think in here for connecting. That's right, I need to connect the object. That's never going to return error, is it? Oh, it is. Okay. Let me think. Yeah. Okay. So it's just object. Different interface, okay. All right, let's give it a go. So I'm just going to just bomb out here, I think. I'm just going to try it. So I do object is equal to the connection, get an object, and in this case, the destination is going to be org.a11. Us, and then org and bus. I don't think Yeah, don't end it off with a slash, that's okay. Okay. And then I need to get the address. So which I presume is a string, isn't it? And then we'll do basically the same as below there. Well, in what do I do here? I just do this simple stuff here. What are the flags? Basically none I need, I think. Okay, so definitely don't want that. Don't want that. I'm doing, not doing anything pocket, right? So it's zero for me. Okay. No flags. Right. I'm just gonna wing it for the moment. While we're just doing this exploratory stuff. Actually, should that be... capitalized? But not on the object, correct? Correct. Okay. And we want here get address. And we're not passing any extras. And we're looking to stuff that into address. Can't get the address, we will bomb out. Now to get any plus address. Okay. Right, let's take that, just stick that there for the moment. And we'll just comment all this out for the moment because I'm going to just give it a quick run and see if it even connects. Okay. So in theory, we're coming in, connecting to the session bus, and we go, hey, can I have the alley bus object, please? And then I call on it the method getAddress, store the result into the address variable, print out an error if that doesn't do the do, and otherwise just print the address, which could be messy, but we'll see. Let's see what it does. Okay. Well, that's all right then. Okay. Cool. So that worked. So let's go one step further then. And let's call something on the actual bus. What have we got available? Bus Has it got anything in here that will help me? No. That's just the launcher stuff. Let's see what else we've got. Don't think that's what gonna need. No. So let's have a look at, I think I've got some other stuff. That's what I looked at just now, I think. Yep. Constants. Where's this? Oh, AT-SPI itself. These are useful, but I don't think it's what I want right now. So for example, AT-SPI event type, that is what I'll be needing later when I get the keystrokes. Here we go. Right, these are the things I want. So I want to listen initially to event stuff to get window changes. Like this window's just become active. This control's just become active, stuff like that. And then device event listener is like I pressed a button. So that's okay. That is the stuff I want. I should probably be looking up proper documentation here. But that's... I've got to find it. See what we've got. That might do it. Okay. That's not what I want. Not quite what I want. here. Okay. Maybe what I should do is see, this isn't going to help. It's not giving me enough info. Not getting, I just want, a list of stuff really that I can use. Okay. Okay, I could decipher this, I think. This is actually not bad as a way of seeing the details. So I think, right, so what, looking at this, the window stuff. Somehow I need to get this. And that. and see what this is that comes back, which is a string and then UUV. I don't know what the UUVs are. I'll have to find out. That is DBus shorthand for something. But how do I get to the point of listening for these events? Is it this? It's not really giving me a detail here. Let's look, see if there's any other guides. There's nothing there. Let's see, log a bus guide. That's not going to work, is it? AT-SPI DBus interface guide. I don't think we're going to get much. Been there before. Ah, right, okay. I vaguely remember this. Um. That's a load of rubbish. What the? So this is way out of date then. Yeah. Thing. That's not very helpful, is it? Why is it so hard to get information on this stuff? Why is there no info? Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to wing it and just poke. So introspection. Okay, so what I might need to do, so I've got a new address there, so I need to get like an early bus. It's probably gonna have like an error on it, so let's see what we can do with dbus dot connect. What are connection options? Okay, I don't think I need any of that. Okay. Let's try. So we're going to just connect to the address that we've got. So do I not need to do anything there then? Com. And then you're going to basically copy a whole bunch of this. So, we've now got a connection. We now need to start calling on it. So it's a bit more like this, I guess. So we'll do something like cool. Equals alicon dot oops bus. Cool. And then now we need to kind of see what's available. Do we have an XML? How about could try this. So actually it's that and then that. So AT-SPI registry. AT-SPI registry dot that no flags. And then if I could use this. Different bar subject though. I'll try this one shot thing first, just to get a list. We'll see what we can do here. Try that. Well, we could just try that now and see how it ends. See if that even gets anywhere. Right. Walk free desktop DBus. So that means it's not calling the right object there. So I'm not doing that right. So I get a connection. I am doing a connection, am I? DBus connect. I'm using this function. To get a connection. Okay. Maybe I need to do it that way. Okay. Let's do that then. Let's just get the object and then call it. This. That's good. Okay. So we have no idea what we're getting. What are we getting from that? Some sort of an array with a probably like key and value. Who knows? I'll have to look that up, see what DBus does with that kind of stuff. Can I just can I do a sneaky? Can I do like the response? Face, I have no idea, and then oops, yeah, do that, and then call dot store. Actually, it'd make it even easier. Do it in a wanna. See what we get. And then I've got to go stop and go. Cool. Okay. Well, we're getting there. So, something is monitoring a focus, an insert, and deactivate, and minimize, and window shade, lower, close, desktop destroy. And I bet if I do and then do it again. Yeah. It was Snippet Pixie. So Snippet Pixie is looking for a bunch of stuff. It's monitoring for window changes. And in particular, focusing of controls. So if I do it again, still not doing it. If I bring up, actually it's probably easiest. I don't want, I don't want to have control of it there, so I'll do it in the background by doing that. And then if I bring up, if I run that again, we're back to monitoring, because that's what Snippet Pixie needs to do. So that's cool. Okay, so we're getting there. That means I'm starting to understand how to interact with the DBus thing. And this here gives me an idea of how to monitor these events. So I can basically make a channel probably in a thread. So I can go, do a go anonymous function, do this thing, and then just keep responding to these events, as long as they're the right ones. So I don't know whether I can do that kind of stuff. If I can do monitoring like that for different objects, that might just work. But I've got to go. It's time for a stand-up meeting. So until next time, thanks for watching, and you take care.